Hi, church. It's Pastors Jen and Jacob here with today's digital devotion. I cannot believe it is Good Friday today. Today is what it's supposed to be. It's meant to be the heaviest day of the Christian calendar. And so on this day, we remember Jesus's crucifixion. And we often read the passages leading up to it in scripture, which include really difficult passages to read of violence and torture and abuse and all of the darkest parts of humanity that Jesus experienced leading up to his death. You know, what happened on the cross is actually a great mystery in the Christian faith. And depending on who you ask, what branch of Christianity you talk to, what denomination you talk to, you will get very different answers about how people interpret what actually happened on the cross. Some people will say that Jesus died for our sins, and because of his death, we are now atoned and we are cleansed from all of our sin and guilt. Other people will say that Jesus on the cross was God's act of solidarity with all who suffer and are marginalized and oppressed. Other people will say that Jesus dying on the cross was the ultimate act of becoming a scapegoat for those who were in charge at the time. His death was a way of speaking truth to power. I mean, there are many interpretations of, we call it atonement theory, what really happened on the cross.
I didn't know what you were going to talk about when we started, and so I'm curious to hear, what do you make of that? Like, as people of faith, what does it matter what happened on the cross? Which of those ideas people believe? Why is that important?
Well, I think it's left mysterious for good reason, because I think all of us come to the Christian faith with a different theology and with different needs. We're looking to be healed in different ways. And so if you are someone who comes from a minority group, if you are someone who has felt the sting of oppression or marginalization in your life, the story of Jesus dying on the cross is going to feel very different to you and be read very different to you than someone who comes from a background of wealth and privilege and has never felt what it actually means to be oppressed or marginalized. And so, but that doesn't mean that person of privilege and wealth needs Jesus any less in their lives, or, you know, can't find great meaning in the story of the cross. I just think there are different ways to interpret it because we are all different people with different life experiences. I think all are valid. I think all are meaningful. And I honestly think the best atonement theory is a combination of maybe all of those. Mm. And, you know, I think this is the great question that has stumped many theologians across the centuries, because the story is still unfolding. You know, Christ's resurrection is still unfolding. And our lives are a testimony to the fact that God is still speaking. That's our denomination's motto. And the story hasn't ended. And so we can't look back on a finished narrative and say, that's what that meant, because it's still happening now and we're all a part of that.
Wow, that's good. And for me, it's just this idea of whatever happened on the cross, and it's so hard to explain. I mean, how could we know for sure? For me, it's just this moment that is effective in communicating to all of us that we are love and that we are worth dying for. And that's powerful, that moment on the cross is effective for everybody. There's no special prayer that needs to happen in order for me to find salvation, but just God dying for us is this symbol of we're all in. And I think that's powerful for me. You know, Good Friday service is honestly our favorite service of the entire year, because it makes the joy of Easter Sunday that much more impactful. Jen, you love curating Good Friday services. This year's the first time that you've put it into my hands.
I did, yeah.
So I hope it's okay. Obviously, she still wrote the liturgy for
it. It's gonna be great.
But what I was reflecting on this year is the fact that when Jesus is on the cross and he's dying because he can't breathe, it just is so parallel to our experiences in this past year with both COVID and with police brutality and racism. This idea of what does it take for us to just do the simple task of breathing. And so we hope this evening, 7 p.m., you can join us and reflect with us on this idea of having breath and having life. And hopefully, in the midst of the death tonight, we will all collectively find our resurrection on Sunday. Let's pray together.
God, in whom we find our life, we walk with you these final steps to the cross. We walk these steps with heavy hearts, ready to participate in your sorrow and pain. But we also walk these steps with hope, because we believe that this is not the end of the story, and that the most exciting chapter is about to be written in a few days. In your name we pray, amen.
Amen.
We'll see you tonight.